Hello friends, here actually we are going to discuss the Hindu newspaper and its analysis of 15th of November 2017. So here actually first is this news post Doklam India asserts itself in China's backyard. So China's backyard here it means that China's neighboring countries, that is Southeast Asian countries, for example Philippines, Vietnam, Cambodia, Laos, because we know that these countries are also facing some issues, because regarding the South China Sea we have seen China is asserting its power both economically as well as military. Now, because of these reasons, those means China's these countries, Southeast Asian countries, are not able to counter this China's assertiveness. But in the Doklam issue, India has actually shown the China its place, and because of that, image of India has been increased in the eyes of these Southeast Asian countries. So they actually now planning to means push India to actually have a global role or in this world, so that they can contain this China with the help of India. So this is the news regarding that. We need to another, this is Supreme Court dismisses petitions for SIT probe in bribery case. Just go through this news, otherwise there is nothing that we need to read in this news. Another important anti-superstitions bill tabled, that is in Karnataka already, Maharashtra already passed this anti-superstitions bill, especially regarding rationality. So this is in Karnataka, no need to go through completely in this. Another important news is here that India had a decade more to their longevity. So what is this news is? So here news is this, India had a decade more to their longevity. Here actually report is saying that India's life expectancy improved from 59 in 1990 to 68.5 years in 2016. So we need to remember first this fact, for our society wala jo paper hai, that is GS paper 1, where we can add this. So India's life expectancy has increased. So why life expectancy has increased? Because the penetration of public health increased, now nutrition level also increased compared to earlier. Because of this, good transportation is available, accessibility to public health also increase, per capita income of people increase, poverty reduce, and because of all these factors, India's this life expectancy at birth increased from 59 to 68.5. But it has been actually also seen that one thing also we need to know, life expectancy of women is more compared to men, so that also we need to know. The life expectancy of female is around 70.3% and life expectancy for male is 66.9% in 2016. This one more important thing, when it comes to interstate comparison, then we can actually observe that Kerala is having more life expectancy compared to North Indian states. For example, if we compare this Kerala to the Uttar Pradesh, then we can see that in Uttar Pradesh the life expectancy is 66.8 years, and that is below the national average, because national average is 68.5 years. That means Uttar Pradesh life expectancy is 2 years less than this, and when it comes to compare to Kerala, then from Kerala its life expectancy is 12 years less, because Kerala's life expectancy is 78.7 years, but only Uttar Pradesh is 66.8 years. So so friends, you also can go through in this statistics and see where actually your own home state is actually on this statistics. Please go through your own home state also, because it is important to know about your home state also regarding interview. So why actually this is happening? Because reason is Kerala's, we can know that social sector development in Kerala is more compared to the northern Indian states. So in northern Indian state, nutritional level is not good, public health opportunity is not available, accessibility is very less, and available of hospital beds per lakh population is also less compared to Kerala. So because of all these reasons, definitely Kerala is performing well compared to northern state. So that things we need to cover from this page. Now comes to editorial page. So in editorial page we can go through this warmer, that is rich countries must pay for plans to limit and deal with climate change. So already we know there is a Bonn Convention, that is 23rd Conference of United Nations Framework Conventions on Climate Change in Bonn is going on. So where is Bonn? So find out in atlas, go through the atlas and find out where is bone is located. Okay, its locations, whether it is located on a particular river or not, find out this. And then see India's progress, what India has done in regarding this to contain climate change. So India has reduced the intensity of its greenhouse gas. And please see, it is intensity. Okay, intensity in the sense, suppose earlier, intensity means, suppose earlier to produce 100 kg of steel, if India was producing 10 kg of carbon dioxide, but now same 100 kg of, to produce same 100 kg of steel, India is producing only 2 kg of carbon dioxide instead of 10 kg of carbon dioxide earlier. So that is known as intensity reduction. So intensity of its greenhouse gas emissions per unit of GDP by 20 to 25% from 2005 level, that is base year is 2005 levels by 2020, is positive in the sense that definitely India is on right track, because India's intensity is continuously decreasing. And in Paris actually climate deal, India has actually, especially this INDCA, India has promised that India is going to cut greenhouse gas emission intensity by 30 to 35% by 2030. So this also we need to remember. In 2015 Paris Agreement, India has promised that India is going to reduce emission, greenhouse gas emission intensity by 30 to 35% by 2030. And so that this 2 degrees Celsius, that is going to increase, this temperature is going to increase, that temperature should not increase more than 2 degrees Celsius compared to when actually industrialization started. That means whatever the temperature was during 1850s time, so compared to that temperature, the temperature should not increase more than 2 degrees Celsius average. So it is in this context that rich countries must give up their rigid approach. For example, USA. USA is not going to sign this Paris climate deal, and we already know that USA is the largest contributor in terms of this greenhouse gas emission. So that things in author is going to ask that rich countries need to give up this rigid approach towards the demand of low and middle income countries, because low and middle income countries is saying, because we also require development, our population also want development, but for that development we need to use coal and all these carbons, and for that greenhouse gas emission will increase, and then it's going to impact the climate change. So if rich countries want that, we should not do this, then they need to give what? Finance. So what the thing is, the author is saying that rich countries need to give for financing for mitigations, adaptations and compensation technology, that they need to give. At least they need to do this much. So already the country, but suppose example India, for example in India already chalked out ambitious policy on renewable energy, for that hoping to generate 175 gigawatt of power from green sources by 2022. That means 100 gigawatt from solar and rest 75 will come from wind and hydro, hydropower project. So already India has formed international solar mission, India has formed, so that is the, and India has also formed for rooftop solar energy, and India is also going to implement net metering system. Please go through and read what is this net metering system. Is net metering system, yeah, suppose example in your house, suppose example in your house you are having solar power, correct, and suppose in your house solar power means solar power generation is 100 unit daily, but your consumption is only 80 unit. So what will happen? Rest of the 20 units will go from your home to the common transmission line of this electricity, and then it will go out. That means you are selling this 20 units outside. So for that government will going to pay you the money. That is known as net metering system. Means what? See, suppose example you require 50 or suppose 80 units of electricity you require. In this 80 units, some of the units will come direct from the electricity, some of the units will come from the solar. So it could be seen whether you are giving solar units more than compared to getting electricity from the government, how much. So if you are giving more, you will going to earn the money. If you are not, then you are not going to earn the money. That is net metering system. One more thing is happening in Bonn conference, that is transport decarbonization alliance. So what this, please remember this very important, transport decarbonization alliance. So iska aims kya hai? Aims is at achieving a shift to sustainable fuels, aim is achieving a shift to sustainable fuels. Second is getting cities to commit to eco-friendly mobility and delivering more walkable communities. So what India has done, isse fayda kya hoga? What will the benefit will happen? Ki urban life will improve, pollution level will decrease. That's what Delhi wants. So for Delhi, we can suggest this transport decarbonization alliance. And friends, it is not even Delhi's issue, is it is issue in every city, because every cities are not measuring the way Delhi is measuring this pollution. That is why it is looks like that Delhi is having more pollution. But the way Delhi is measuring the pollution, if we started measuring the pollution in every city, then definitely other cities are equally culpable in terms of pollution. So what India is doing regarding this to make urban life good? India is also actually ambitious program to introduce electric mobility through buses first and cars by 2030. And one more thing, a national law to raise the efficiency of transport could well be the answer. We need to legislate a national law to raise the efficiency of transport. Could be well be the answer, which the states will readily adopt if supportive financial arrangements are built in. That is the thing. Now comes to another article. So another article is this: a question of probity, urgent reform is required to restore the moral authority of the Supreme Court. This is actually the case of one public trust, especially in the medical education, where it was alleged that some judges of the Supreme Courts are involved. At that time, our present Chief Justice of India, he was the judge. So actually in petition, actually the person is accusing that Chief Justice of India, Deepak Mishra, is also one of the accused in that bribery case. But now he is the Chief Justice of India. So they actually petitioned in the Supreme Court to form a bench for the SIT probe. But who is going to constitute that bench? Since he is the Chief Justice of India, and Chief Justice of India is the main person to constitute the branches, correct? So now he is involved in this particular case also, there is a conflict of interest comes. So here actually question is saying whether it is the question of legality versus morality. So what is the issue? So what actually we need to cover here is, here actually the thing is that recently Chief Justice of India held that allocation of business among other branches is his sole prerogative, and this is a customary practice and was affirmed in DC Saxena versus CJI case. So here actually author is saying that whatever Chief Justice of India is saying that to decide the benches, it is Chief Justice of India's sole prerogative. It is not a law, it is a customary practice only, and that was already affirmed in very old case of DC Saxena versus Chief Justice of India. The said practice is aimed at keeping judiciary in discipline and avoid any scandalous accusations from other stakeholders. Now thing is that issue becomes complex when Chief Justice of India is asked for recusal from a case. What then should he do? Is it fair still then to allocate the business as he likes, or rationality or constitutionality shall prevail upon customary law? Whether rationality and constitutionally law should prevail upon this customary law, because whatever the thing is, it is just a customary law. So reason in favor of the argument is this: Chief Justice of India is the supreme, means leader, our supreme authority in judiciary premises. Recent rising conflict between the judges make supreme authority to handle the case effectively, and governing power should be within the hands of one person, not from two different person. But reason against argument is no one is above the law, and no one can become the judge in his own law, on in his own cases. So ye jo isko bolte canons of the law. Canons of the law is no one is above law. Another is ki no one can be, means can be the judge of his own case. So here is when Chief Justice of India's already in his question how he can become the judge in his own case. So no one is above law. Who will be responsible if Chief Justice of India himself found guilty in some case? So loss of confidence in Chief Justice of India will act as a shadow on the justice delivery. And third is judicial corruptions and favoritism issue will be significant, correct? So transparency and accountability in highest institutions instill confidence, correct? So this transparency and accountability, ethics ka paper ho gaya ye. So ethics paper mein we need to know ki some values are required, that is transparency and accountability in highest institution instill confidence in common people. So judicial accountability need to be ensured, but at the same time it needs to be kept in mind that people with vested interest are not allowed for forum shopping in the name of justice and shall be dealt with strict measures such as contempt of the court. Here means that aisa nahi koi bhi mu utha ke aa jaye and petition file kar de. So this thing should not be there. For that contempt of the court must be issued. Otherwise kya hoga ki then scandalous cases will come and they are going to lower the authority of or they are going to lower the independence of judiciary. That is the case. Now comes to another article we are moving, that's labeling versus outcome. Study on the Swachh Bharat Mission do not confirm the government claims. The government is claiming this number of toilets we have built, okay, this record we have made, but whether actually like open defection state became recently, we have actually heard that Mumbai became open defection okay city, but then camera persons actually or reporters has highlighted that many people are still going outside, they are not having toilets, or even they are having toilets, they are not using toilets. So thing is that there must be an output versus outcome. Output kya hai? Swachh Bharat Mission output is just how many numbers of toilet has been built. Outcome kya hai? Outcome is how many number of toilets has been used by the beneficiaries. So second, that is outcome is more important compared to outcome. So here actually author is discussing about that. So thing is this, labeling versus outcome. Here is Swachh Bharat Mission is one of the flagship program of the government. So achievements kya hai? क्या अचीवमेंट किए इन स्वच्छ भारत मिशन में कि इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट हुआ है, दैट इज थाउजेंड्स ऑफ टॉयलेट्स हैव बीन कंस्ट्रक्टेड, एम्पावरिंग वुमेन हुआ है, दैट इज इंक्रीज इन यूसेज ऑफ दीज लेटरिंस बाय वुमेन व्हिच विल एम्पावर वुमेन एंड गिव हर a sense of social security. Toilet movies must you have seen. Empowerment of women, so women asking for divorce due to the lack of toilets we have seen. Toilet movie mein ki we are not going to coming back to your home because in your home there is no toilet. So that means it is empowering the women to ask something that is their actually right, that is their rights. Another important hua kya achievement ki construction of separate toilets for girls and boys okay in schools. So this actually prevent the dropout ratio, because it has been seen ki in this primary and secondary or higher secondary level mein drop rates was high among the girls because there was no separate toilets were available. So that the reason is girls used to not go to the school because of unavailability of toilet. So when toilets has been developed separately for boys and girls, then it prevent the dropout ratio. These are the achievement. Other is open defection states are seen as healthier with good human development index. It has been seen those states which are declared open defection free, for example Sikkim, so it has been seen ki they are having synonyms with their human development index is always high, because when open defection nahi hoga, then what will happen? Hygiene will prevail, water contaminations will not there. Like this year UPSC is asked question, wash scheme kya hai? Wash means that is water and hygiene, and another is important is open defection, that is toilet. So thing is that when open defection free state is there, hygiene will be high here, then this contaminations of water will not be there, and definitely automatically nutrition absorbability will increase and vulnerability of the person will increase, because of that person will become more healthier. So that is also one of the significant achievement of Swachh Bharat Mission. Lekin challenges kya hai Swachh Bharat Mission ke, ki mere construction of toilet does not solve the issue. Okay, behavioral change is the need of the hour. Gaon mein jao, unse bahas karo, you are doing argument why you are not going to toilet, they will give you counter argument. So first we need to change their behavioral mindset, their attitudinal changes is required ki they should use toilet, they should not go outside. Another second challenge is many local governments are pressurized to attain their target, which renders doubt in equality and efficiency of these structures. Ki unko target de diya jata hai ki how many numbers of toilet you this much number of toilets every village panchayat need to build. Isme kya hota hai target mein their structure bhi sahi nahi banayenge, their water facility is not available, so how this toilet is going to be used, or toilet when eventually government or this quality काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया ऑब्जर्व करता है कि हाउ मेनी टॉयलेट्स हैज बीन बिल्ट और दिस, तो उसमें बस यही देखते हैं, दे सी ओनली दिस थिंग कि वेदर हाउ मेनी नंबर्स ऑफ टॉयलेट हैज बीन बिल्ट, दैट्स इट, वेदर दे आर एक्चुअली एंड दे एक्चुअली इफ सपोज एग्जाम्पल कि सपोज एग्जाम्पल इन वन पर्सन सम टॉयलेट हैज बीन बिल्ड, वन क्वालिटी काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया एक्चुअली पर्सन केम एंड आस्क टू दैट पर्सन वेदर यू आर यूजिंग टॉयलेट, एंड देन डेफिनेटली इज गोइंग टू से यस वी आर यूजिंग द टॉयलेट, ओके, बट वेदर एक्चुअली ही इज यूजिंग द टॉयलेट, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन. Third is new technologies must be incorporated such as bio toilets where less water and mature can be generated at the same time. This is very lengthy things because it is over ambitious things. We are not able to even use this bio toilet in our railway also. Awareness program must be frequent and must include locals, community participation is required, like various cultural factors like construction of toilet in the house is considered polluting the house, needs to be changed. So these things need to be change. So this was the third article, that's the labeling of outcomes. After that, any article that we need to cover is forgotten duel. You can just read this article and this, please read this interview also. So that is the important things. One more thing, battle for ICG seat deadlocked. ये भी पढ़ना है यार. एक्चुअली अवर दिस दलवीर सिंह भंडारी इज एक्चुअली अगेंस्ट द यूके यूनाइटेड किंगडम ऑफ ब्रिटेन वन पर्सन दैट इज क्रिस्टोफर ग्रीनवुड. एंड इट यहाँ पे हाउ दे हैव बीन इलेक्टेड, इलेक्शन के लिए एक्चुअली वोटिंग होता है. वोटिंग कहाँ पे होता है? यूनाइटेड नेशन जनरल असेंबली एंड यूनाइटेड नेशन सिक्योरिटी कमीशन यूएनएससी. यूएनएससी में 15 मेंबर्स है एंड यूनाइटेड नेशन जनरल असेंबली में ऑल मेंबर्स है, मीन्स डेवलपिंग डेवलप्ड एवरी मीन्स टूगेदर. बट क्या देखा गया, वॉट इट हैज बीन सीन कि दलवीर भंडारी has won actually battle in United Nations General Assembly jahan pe every member is there, but he is fight means he is having problem in United Nations Security Council mein, because the candidate next, the opposition candidate is Greenwood and that is actually belongs to UK and UK is the permanent member and definitely he can block the election of Dalveer Bhandari. So here even Shashi Tharoor is saying that ki when Dalveer Bhandari is winning United Nations General Assembly, so it already saying that, see here Shashi Tharoor statement, as the United Security Council and General Assembly vote to choose a judge for the International Court of Justice between Indian and UK candidate, the legitimacy and effectiveness of the United Nations are at stake. The voice of General Assembly has been ignored too long, he said in a tweet. And this time a nominee of a permanent member of this Security Council has failed to get an absolute majority of this General Assembly for the first time in direct contest to a major United Nations organ. कि जब आपका बंदा is not able to win the vote United Nations General Assembly, then how it is legitimate to continue with this UNSC? That the thing is, he is asking for United Nations Security Council reform. और भी आपको ध्यान रखना है, व्हाट इज दिस इंटरनेशनल कोर्ट ऑफ जस्टिस, और ध्यान रखना व्हाट इज इंटरनेशनल क्रिमिनल कोर्ट एंड वेदर इंडिया इज अ मेंबर ऑफ आईसीजी और इंटरनेशनल क्रिमिनल कोर्ट. इंडिया इज अ मेंबर ऑफ ओनली आईसीजी बट इंडिया इज नॉट ए मेंबर ऑफ इंटरनेशनल क्रिमिनल कोर्ट. दोनों के ऑब्जेक्टिव्स क्या है, दैट ऑल्सो वी नीड टू नो. एंड दोनों में ये देखना है कि वेयर देयर हेडक्वार्टर कहाँ पे है, वेयर दीज हेडक्वार्टर्स आर, दैट ऑल्सो यू नीड टू नो. अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट यहाँ पे इंडिया रशिया चॉपर डील ऑन द राइट ट्रैक. सो डिफेंस डील क्या है रिगार्डिंग दिस कामोव 2260 यूटिलिटी हेलीकॉप्टर्स में है, जिसमें 140 हेलीकॉप्टर्स विल बी असेंबल्ड इन HAL और बिल्ट इन HAL, रेस्ट ऑफ द 60 विल बी डायरेक्टली फ्लाई इन कंडीशन फ्रॉम रशिया विल कम. ये आपको इतना पढ़ना है. ज्वाइंट ट्रेनिंग डॉक्ट्रीन क्या है फॉर आर्म फोर्सेज, दैट ऑल्सो वी कैन कवर. सो दिस इज इन दिस न्यूज पेपर. अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट आई डोंट थिंक ओके देर इज एनी अदर थिंग इज, सो यू कैन कवर. सो दिस इज द एंड ऑफ दिस डिस्कशन एंड प्लीज लाइक द वीडियो एंड कमेंट इफ एनीथिंग इज रिक्वायर फर्दर. थैंक यू.